टुडे वी आर कंप्लीटिंग चैप्टर 3। वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन, दिस इज डॉक्टर संकेत चरखा फ्रॉम सीनियर गुड इंस्टीट्यूट पुणे। वी आर टेकिंग टुडे सब्जेक्ट ऑफ लीगल एस्पेक्ट ऑफ बिजनेस इन विच वी हैव स्टार्टेड विद द थर्ड चैप्टर ऑफ नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट एक्ट ऑफ 1881। वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज आरबीआई एक्ट ऑफ 1934, व्हाट इज इंडियन पेपर करेंसी एक्ट ऑफ 1871 एंड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ नेगोशिएबल इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स। देन we have seen various features of negotiable instrument with respect to freely transferable, defection title, remedy, rights, payable to order, payable to bearer, payment, consideration and presumptions of negotiable instruments. Presumptions as to consideration, date, time of acceptance, time of transfer, order of endorsement, stamp, holder in due course and proof of protest. Types of instrument, bill of exchange, check and promissory note and for usage or customs of trade, bank note, share certificate, share warrant, dividend warrant, deeds and government promissory notes. Definition of promissory note. A promissory note is defined as an instrument in writing containing an unconditional promise or undertaking signed by the maker to pay certain sum of money or to the order or to the bearer of the instruments. Two parties, maker and payee. Then types of promissory note, payable on demand, payable after date, joint promissory note and joint and several. Then bill of exchange, definition, an instrument in writing containing an unconditional order. So here bill of exchange is an order, whereas promissory note is just a promise. The promise may be fulfilled, may not be fulfilled, but the bill of exchange has to be performed because it is a specific order for a certain specific person to perform in the respective consideration or in that particular manner to pay a certain sum of money or to the order or to the bearer of the instrument. Then types of bill of exchange, demand bill, time bill, inland bill, foreign bill, trade bill and accommodation bill. Definition of check, a check is a bill of exchange drawn on a specified banker and not expressed to people otherwise on demand. So unless and until the parties demand, the payment to a check cannot be made. Parties to a check, maker, drawee, payee, holder, endorser and endorsee. Types of check, open check, cross check, bearer, order, stale, post dated, account payee, non-negotiable and crossed more than once. Then different points of differentiation between check, promissory note and bill of exchange. All these things here you can see on the screen are completely theoretical perspectives. We have gone through it in detail one by one. Then for the slides you have checks, crossing of check, open check and a cross check. So different types of crossing are general, special and restrictive. In each perspective, that is general, special and restrictive, you have three types of crossings into existence. Then essential elements of a check must be in writing, express order to pay, must be signed by a drawer, must be an order to pay, certain sum, three parties, specified banker and lastly payable on demand. Liabilities of parties in negotiable instrument, liabilities of the drawer, drawee, payee, liability of endorser and endorsee, liability of holder in due course, liability of principal debtor, liability of acceptor and lastly liability of a specified banker or authority. Types of endorsement, blank or general, special or full, partial, restrictive and conditional. Conditional further divided into four categories, sans recourse, facultative, sans fiance, contingency. Then when the dishonor of a negotiable instrument. So when a negotiable instrument can get dishonored or it can be rejected for payment. First thing, drawee do not accept within 48 hours. So if the person who has prepared or the person for whom the negotiable instrument is to be accepted, if it is not been accepted within the 48 hours, then the negotiable instruments can be getting dishonored. Several drawees and one or more do not accept. So if there are several parties associated with the negotiable instrument and any one party to the instrument does not accept within a specific time period or several out of the several number of parties, one party also do not accept, then the negotiable instrument can get dishonored. If it is not been accepted, either the drawer or either the drawee, either that is a single drawee or several number of drawees, if they are not accepting the negotiable instrument based on the certain terms and conditions, then in that case also the negotiable instruments can be dishonored. Drawee is incompetent to enter into contract. So parties who are incompetent to enter into contract, from those perspective or from that particular reference, you can understand about when a negotiable instruments can be dishonored. Drawee gives qualified acceptance. So here, as we have seen in terms of presumptions of the essential elements of a negotiable instrument, every instrument must be unqualified. So without any terms and conditions. So if any terms and condition is being laid by a specified person, that is either by the drawee or other by the drawer, then here in this case, it becomes a qualified acceptance. And based on this consideration, the negotiable instruments can be dishonored. And lastly, drawee becomes a fictitious person. Who is a fictitious person? The person who cannot be identified and his identity cannot be found to be genuine. So in this case, a particular person, if he becomes fictitious, that is, he cannot be identifiable, then in that case, the negotiable instruments can be dishonored. Bouncing or dishonor of check. Yes, we have also seen this. What are the various reasons in which the check can be dishonored, or in simple terms, you say that the check is bounced. Irregular endorsement, material alteration, loss of check, stop payment, garnish or the court order or specific order of a court, death notice of withdrawer, insolvency of withdrawer, insanity, assignment of credit balance, defects in title, and lastly, the notice of closure. Then we have seen what are the various reasons in which the banks may refuse to make the payment. That is, you have either presented a check to a particular banker and what are the various reasons in which the bank will refuse to make the payment to the interested party. First thing, insufficient funds. So if the balance in your account, that is the funds in your account are not, if they are not maintainable, that is the check was drawn for rupees 10,000 and if the fund in the account are rupees 9,000 or if it is 999 also, still the check cannot be getting cleared because there are insufficient funds from this clause or this particular criteria, the check does not get cleared and it cannot be honored. Funds not applicable, that is if the check is written in dollar currency and if you are presenting in Indian bank for a rupee currency, then in this case also, based on the applicability of the funds, the check can be dishonored. Proper place of presentment, so if the check is specifically drawn for a Pune city, Mumbai city, Delhi city, and if the place check is presented at some wrong location or wrong place, then in that case also, the bank may refuse to make the payment. Presentment after banking hours. So if the banking hours are specified, that is from 10 to 4 or 10 to 5 or 11 to 6, whatever, depend on it changes from bank to bank. And if you visit a bank after the banking hours or before the banking hours, then accordingly your check, the bank may refuse to make the payment. Stale check notice. So if a particular bank has received a certain notice with respect to the check has been lost and it has and the necessary party may receive a certain amount of payment. So here in this case, if you give a certain notice for the loss of a check, then accordingly in this case we can see that we can say that the particular check is dishonored or the bank may refuse to make the payment to you. Next we have post-dated check. So if a check has been drawn as on today and accordingly if the date that has been mentioned on that particular check is the not as on today, then here in this case on the consideration of the date that has been identified or that on that particular check, the check can be getting dishonored and accordingly the bank will refuse to make the payment. Undated check, again if the check is not dated properly, if the date is not mentioned on that particular check, then here in this case the check is refused for making the payment by the respective banker. Expired check, this check which has been presented for payment after the due date, and lastly signature mismatch. Have we done this all? I think it is completed. Discharge of negotiable instrument, payment in due course by cancellation, primary party becomes the primary holder, express waiver and discharge by simple contract. I think we have completed. Okay, discharge of parties by payment, cancellation, release of any one party, allowing drawee more than 48 hours, taking qualified acceptance, giving notice of dishonor, non-presentation for the acceptance, delay in presenting the negotiable instrument, no proper banker, and lastly, the material alteration. Yeah, I think we have done with this slide. Okay, any difficulty at this stage with respect to Negotiable Instrument Act? If you would like to ask any questions, you can please unmute yourself and ask me for any of these student. Or do we move ahead with the next chapter? We are starting with the fourth chapter today. Soham, Prashil, Kunal, Dada, what do we do? Let me know. Continue.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir, continue, please.
Yes, sir, continue.
Starting with the new topic, that is Companies Act 1956. Just a minute, I'll close it and we'll start with the new.